Oui, buenos días.
Ven aquí, mi amor. Ven aquí. Tengo cositas que contarte.
¡Madre!
¡Ay!
Get away from her.
Thank you, señor. I should know by now, I never to tell a man he has una verga pequeña.
Don't mention it, miss.
Cabrón.
Oiga, you need a ride?
Come on! How are you, friend? That's what I want.
¿Se siente bien?
Hello, sir.
Veremos si con esto te sientes mejor. Lo que usted desee. Los rebeldes de Reyes desaparecen en escalera. Vuélvame a ver si tiene malos resultados. ¿Cómo está?
Hola. Welcome to my store.
Why, hello.
Capitán de Santa solo permite que yo le toco a su pistola.
Buenas.
As you like.
Why do I feel like I just got robbed?
Thank you for visiting my tienda.
After working all day, I like to smoke Don Filiberto.
Let's go!
Yeah! pagar por mis molestias.
Oh, give it away!
You know you're gonna die, right? Forgive me, friend. I need it more than you now. beauty.
Doing out here? What if someone saw it? They go straight to Marshal Johnson and Armadillo and tell him where it was, wouldn't it?
I don't know.
Sometimes I swear y'all fellas must be dumber than a fence post.
Mister, these fellas robbed a bank in Armadillo. I've been tracking them ever since. I'm a bit outnumbered. Would you mind lending your gun?
Come on, you set a nut crack.
Officer, I do apologize.
You are a bad man, mister!
Man, that one almost got me.
Thank you.
see that again. I cannot thank you enough, sir.
Let's go.
Who put something in my
drink? Go see.
So long.
Good day.
Marshall was sure looking at you this morning. That's like the Mexicans call this garage.
Excuse me.
You want a good time?
I'm afraid my wife wouldn't appreciate it, ma'am. Why, hello.
My products are of the finest quality, sir.
Thank you very much.
Please come again.
That's what I wanted. Come on! lucky. I ain't as bad as some folk I know. All right, let's go.
Jack!
You get smelly.
Ain't no rope can hold me for long. You want to stop me, you best shoot me.
Good piece of dirt. Thank you.
Mr. Marston, thank God I found you. When I heard of your good deeds, I knew I had to seek you out. We sisters had a collection to help further your cause in this wicked land.
Boy, I would like to get my farmer's hands
on that
sod.
Thanks. Excuse me, madam. Come on. yourself there.
Be your pardon, there.
I was talking to some Blackwater fellas last night. Seemed kind of snooty.
Hello there.
I got nothing but good, honest profit.
Hello there.
That's enough, friend.
Thanks for stopping by. A good shopkeeper.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Hey, partner.
One must take care of one's body. It's where
I don't know how you get away with these prices, mister.
Come back anytime.
Hello.
Let's see what you have.
Thank you very much.
I hope to see you again. Not due to injury or illness, obviously.
Let's go! Easy. I've been after? That's what I wanted. There we go. That's one. Might as well. Come on! Let's go! That's the flower. Yeah.
looks like the one.
Incredible. Simply incredible.
Hello, Professor.
Hello, sir. Oh, Mr. Marston, sir. Good day, good day. How are you?
Well, my family's health and well-being are being threatened by some unscrupulous government agents, and my own hard-won freedom is under duress. But these problems aside, I suppose I'm fair.
Yes, the problems of civilizing nomads. Tell me, sir, are you from Norse stock?
Not as far as I know. I was raised in an orphanage. My father was Scottish.
Unfortunate. You'd make an interesting case for my theory of natural population characteristics.
Really?
Well, yes. A white man, obviously, but with a savage spirit. Trust me, sir, I mean savage in the best possible sense. Natural nobility, but also simple. Pure. I've been looking at some blood samples through my microscope, and you know what?
No.
Oh, well, of course you don't. It's a remarkable breakthrough. I've been looking at the blood of both natives and white men of corresponding height, weight, and age, and you know what?
Again, no.
They're exactly the same. It's remarkable. It completely refutes my last book. But I'll tell you what, sir. This sabbatical in the field may have been somewhat forced upon me by circumstance, but my scholarship has benefited enormously. Would you like to partake of a syringe of cocaine? I've quite enough for two.
Not right this minute, no.
Oh, it's a remarkable drug. It entirely restores the ego. It takes one back to a primal state. It helps my thinking enormously. Oh, Nastas, come on. Come in, sir. Would you like to take off your slippers? Or skin a rabbit? I know. We cannot see the stars, but still my heart is pure, and we meet as equals. These savages must be spoken to simply in metaphors.
No, sir. I grew up on a reservation and attended school.
Oh, lovely.
But I can show you what you want to see. I know where the group of bandits you seek are hiding, both of you. Van der Linde has attracted a following of young men on the reservation. They are turning to bad things.
The savage heart cannot be conventionally civilized. I was right all along.
Where's Dutch Van Der Linde based?
In the hills, in Cochinay. Let's go. I know a way there that is not guarded.
Marvelous. It's simply marvelous.
Hello, sir.
A scientist, a criminal, and a savage. What a strange trinity we make.
Come, let's hurry. Stay close.
So, I understand we have a mutual interest in Mr. Van der Linde.
You gonna kill him too?
Kill him?
Yeah.
Oh, God, no. What is it with you people out here? No, Van der Linde fascinates me. A white man living among natives. A civilized mind turned savage. It's reverse integration or regressive acculturation. I don't know. I haven't found a name I like yet.
He was never that civilized.
Ah, but of course. Edgar Ross mentioned your unique history with the man. Although I was away with the fairies at the time, I must admit. Surfing great waves of euphoria. Ah, but... Anyway, yes, some kind of Robin Hood, Oedipus, communist tale of naivete and betrayal, if I remember correctly.
We ran in a gang together, Professor. I didn't try to read too much into it.
It's my job to read too much into everything, dear boy. Are you sure this is the right way?
Yes, sir.
It's rather dark.
Ain't you never seen trees before? I thought you were a brand cultural explorer.
It's this way, mister.
Good Lord, no. I rarely leave my room. I explore with the mind, Mr. Marston.
Enjoy it while you still can. Soon you will have cut down all of these trees.
Me? Or are you making a sweeping statement about the white man in general?
There is no respect for the land anymore.
I'm sensing some hostility, Nastas. Some anger. Talk me through this primal emotion, where it's coming from.
Don't worry about it, Professor. Is here and climb the rest of the way. Whoa, whoa!
Remarkable. I'm afraid I don't really have much of a head for heights. More of a head for highs. Well, anyway, I'm sure Nastas will help you. I must be on my way. I've got work to do.
Thanks for the help.
Goodbye, gentlemen. Enjoy yourselves!
Let's get moving, mister! See if you can find another route, Mr. Marston. I will have a look around. I think there's a path through this cave. Yes, look at this, a mine shaft. Thank you. This way! I'm hurt pretty bad.
I don't think you should go any further.
I'll be fine, but you go ahead. I don't want to slow you down.
You sure you're all right?
Just need to take it slow. Go on. I'll catch up or see you on the way down. Don't worry about me. Go look for Van der Linde. Good luck. Go ahead. I just need to rest a while. Thank you.
Mr. Marston? Mr. Marston! Mr. Marston! Here you go, Mr. Marston.
Put that stuff away.
You banged your head. Nastus and I carried you down. Nastus heard the shots and he hurried up to rescue you and he carried you down. I improvised an escape plan. I'm more of a planner than a man of action.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Friends of mine are with Van der Linde.
We must try to reason with them, sir. Vanderland's gang contains several natives. We must meet with them and try to save them from disaster.
My people have already endured many disasters. Before, this was all our land.
And now we have brought you civilization. Sure, it hasn't been easy, but it hasn't been easy for anyone, Nastus. Why, I knew a man in Yale whose father once shot 18 natives in one afternoon out in Wyoming. Oh, the man was quite traumatized. He took to lying with choir boys.
For a wise man, you are a very stupid man, mister.
Gentlemen, I'm going to leave you to figure out right from wrong.
You are simple-minded, sir. Thus, I do not blame you for not understanding reason. Then again...
How is this evening treating you?
That's how you're going now.
Turn the other cheek to sodomy, or you will surely burn.
Hello.